Welcome to our live training session number 28, part 3. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at doing our high cam fuel and ignition timing tuning, as well as learning how to set our VTEC engagement point. We're going to have a lot to cover, so let's jump into our live training session so we can get started. Welcome back to our live training session here with our supercharged Honda S2000. Now in the last video, we mapped out our low cam of operation, so we tackled our fuel and ignition timing for idle, part throttle, and wide open throttle conditions. So we've gotten all that dialed in. We went through the process of taking a look at our NOC ignition limit tables and how they were affecting our spark timing, and we also saw that the wideband was having some odd readings and how to distinguish if that was valid air fuel readings or not based on our injector pulse width. So we know how to do all that now, ready to move into our high cam of operation. Before we do that, we need to go in, set our VTEC engagement point low, and we need to take a look at our fuel and ignition timing values from our low cam of operation. We're able to use those and guide us in how much spark timing we can run on our high cam tables compared to our low cam to get started, and then also taking a look at the fuel delivery and demands from the low cam to the high cam. So let's first jump into our parameter section here. We're going to go into our VTEC engagement. We're going to drop it down. So my VTEC window here, I'm going to be setting this just as a guess here to 3600. And I'll go here and set my lower boundary map pressure here to 102 kPa. It's the highest we can set it. And then here in the upper boundary, I'll set it to something like 5000. And then I'll go here to something like 90 kPa. That way we have a floating point. So it can go as low as 3600 if we're at least 102 kPa or 0 psi. And then it can go here and have VTEC at 5,000 if our manifold pressure here is, let's even say, drop it down here a little bit, 85 kPa, which is going to be in vacuum. Now, unfortunately, K-Pro can't scale our VTEC engagement based on positive manifold pressure. So we can see here, if I try to enter a value here of 120 kPa, which is about 2 pounds of boost, it reverts it right back to 102. Not a big deal, but we just need to be aware that it's not going to be able to have our load threshold any higher than 102. So these settings right now will work great for a supercharged car. So we're going to try it. We might have to tweak our VTEC engagement point a little bit, but we'll figure out where that's going to be at in the next few pulls here after we set this all up. So now we set our VTEC engagement point to be there. We're going to have to go into our spark timing table here on our low cam and take a look what we were seeing part throttle and spark. So we're going to find here right around 3000, we're seeing about 30 to 32 degrees of spark timing here, depending on where we're at on the table. That means part throttle here, I'm going to be saying between my columns 1 and 6, I'll do Control J, I'll put something like 32 degrees of timing. I'm going to be expecting I can run at least that much on my high cam table. And then as I transition here into boost, we're going to be dropping our timing back. Now let's take a look on our low cam, what we found for spark timing. We were hitting right around 9-10 pounds of boost at 7,000 RPM. If we actually take a look here, jumping into graph, looking at the top here, we can see 9 pounds of boost, 9.5, about 18 degrees of timing. So we're able to take that value there, 17, 18 degrees, and put it into our high cam. We know we can start there. That should give us good starting points. And we're gonna probably have another 4, 5, 6 degrees ignition timing higher than that on our high cam of operation. We don't know exactly where we're gonna be at, but we should be pretty close. So my columns 12 through 13 here, jumping into my high cam, I'm gonna be setting these to a value here. I'll go and set this to a value of 18. I'll set my column 13 here, 12.
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.